Welcome back. So last video we have seen how do we check whether a user given number is prime or not. Okay. So now in the beginning of this video, we will just see a small change in that program. We'll do a small change in that program and that make the program 100% faster. Okay. So what is going to happen is a small concept that you just have to remember. Let's say you have a number 13. So our logic what we have followed for checking for prime is we are dividing 13 by numbers from 2 to 11. Okay. If the remainder of division of 13 by any of this number is 0, then that means that number is a factor of 13 and it is not a prime number. In 13th case, it will not happen. If you divide 13 by any of the number, the remainder will not be 0. Okay. So one small observation that you have to make is if you divide 13 by 7, 13 by 8, up to 13 by 11. All these will give a number which is between 2 and 1. Okay, so what is 1? 13 by 13 is 13 by 12 also I have to include. 13 by 13 is 1. Okay, so what is 7? 7 is some value which is greater than 13 by 2. Okay, 13 by 2 is something around 6.5. So 7. So from a value which is greater than the number by 2 to the number itself. Okay. So this, if you divide the number, the actual value, the resultant will be 2 to 1. So that means whatever number is beyond the half of the user given number, all those numbers cannot be a factor of the given number. Okay, so that means we are unnecessarily doing these divisions. 50% of the divisions that we are doing. So we are dividing from 2 to 11. So what we are telling you is this: from 7 to 11, this division is not required because it cannot yield a factor because the remainder will be 2 to 1. Okay, check the case of 6. So 6 means what is the factors? 2 and 3. When we are checking with this code, we'll divide 6 by 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. And 6 by 2 is 3. So when we divide by 2, it is divisible. Divide by 3, it is divisible. When we divide by 4 and 5, this will give a value which is less than 2. And this cannot be a factor of 6. So any number you take, you just have to divide by numbers from 2 to half of the number, including the half of the number. Okay. So what change we are going to do is we are going to divide the numbers by from 2 to number by 2. Right. So when we do this, what happens is we are actually saving 50% of the work, because after from number by 2 to number minus 1, all those set of 50% numbers we are avoiding, because even if we divide, we will not get a remainder factor. Okay. So using that, we are making the code faster. Right. So that is the first thing that I want to tell you. The second part is we want to modify this program so that we have to list all the prime numbers. So instead of that, modify the above program to list all the prime numbers from 2 to a user given number. Now, how do we do this? Okay, so this is so what you're going to learn now is a very key aspect. Every time when you want to write a program, 60-70% of the time you have to use the logic that we are going to use now. Okay. So what happens is, again, the idea is simple. What you'll do is, user will give you a number, let's say 12. You have to list all the prime numbers from 2 to 12. So what is that? 2, 3, 7, okay, level. So your output should be this. Output. Okay. You can also imagine this program in some other way. Think that you're using the same program, but instead of user giving input, so this program was to check whether the user given value is prime or not. So what you'll do is you have to start from 2 up to the user given number, check each number whether the number is prime or not. Okay. So whatever we have been doing, this exercise you have to keep on doing for numbers from 2 to the user given number. So that means we have to use one more while loop, and that while loop should be having this while loop inside that. So this is a loop inside a loop. Okay. So how do we do this? Let's say now what we have to do is we have to start from 2 to the user given number. Each number you have to keep on checking whether the number is prime or not, right? So we'll just magnifier here. Okay. So this much. This is our code for checking whether a given number is prime or not. So this we have to keep on do this work for each number from 2 to the number which user given, right? So how do we do this? So I'll give a space here. I selected everything and press tab. So when you do that, what happens? I'll just show you again. So this works in most of the IDE environment that you're using. Okay, so enter thing has moved further. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to declare another integer, j, and assign it 2. Okay, so what will happen here is, I will run j from 2 to the user given number, right? So I'll open a bracket here. So this j bracket should be closed here. J plus plus. Okay, so what happens? From 2 to the number, this loop will, whatever portion is here, it will be running. Now what I have to check every time, this j is the value that I have to check for prime or not. Okay, j is 2, with 2 is prime, 3, 3 is prime, 4, 4 is prime. So I have to, how do I check? I have to divide this j from 2 to j. So instead of number, I have to check for j, right? And I'm checking, is j divisible by I? It is divisible by I, flag 1. So this handle is okay. So this loop will run by itself. Once the loop is complete, I'm checking the value of flag is 1. What is the value of flag is 1? Flag is 1 means it is not prime. So in this program, I don't have to do anything when flag is 1. So I just have to do, I'll turn the flag back to 0. So flag is 0 means it's a prime number. So once it is divisible by 2, any number, the flag become 1. So here what happens, I'm keeping on doing it. So once this loop is done, it has to go for the next j. Okay, so next j, we'll assume that j is prime, so that means flag is 0. That is the initial condition for the next loop. Also my I should be 2. So what has happened here, we'll check for one number, the number is divisible. It will break, it will come here. Come here means I'm changing the flag to 0, and I'm changing I back to 2, so that next loop can properly work. Okay, else. So if it is a prime number, what I have to do? I just have to print the number. Printf %d. So what is the number I'm checking? J. J is the number that is being run. Okay, so I'll also use a tab here. So slash t is like slash n. Only thing is slash n gives send it to a next line. Slash t will give a tab. So what is a tab? Tab is the key which is just above your caps lock in your PC. Okay, so let's see. Okay, now I think this is okay. Flag is 0, I is 2, J is increasing. Okay, I put a semicolon here. Now let's run. Enter a number, let's say 25. Oh, see, this is giving me output. 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number, 23 is a prime number. All prime numbers I'm getting. So let's say I'll run again. Let's say 1500. Oh, so just see whether here, this is some small issue. This is 31, the next line is 73. Okay, so be careful with that. Your output is here, it is not displaying correctly. Okay, but again, all the numbers, all the prime numbers from 2 to 1500 is listed here, right? So I hope the program is clear to you. Again, with just 2 more minutes to understand this. So this is my old loop. So this is checking whether J is prime or not. The value of J changes from 2 to the number. So go through the code, understand it properly. It's simple, but you know, just go through once and understand it thoroughly. Okay, see you in the next video.